You know what they say about people with big feet? They've got big brains. Because they're human. Because humans have big brains. That's what this episode's about. Perverts. Hey there, brainy buddies. Jules here for DNews. If you compare the brain of a human to that of a chimp, one of our closest genetic relatives, you'd see a pretty notable difference. The human brain is 3 times larger than the chimp's. By body weight, humans pretty much have some of the biggest brains, pound for pound. To be fair, the award for largest brain in comparison to weight goes to the ant, whose brain makes up about 15% of its mass. But having a larger brain doesn't necessarily make a human or animal smarter. Researchers have long discounted the theory that human brains are so big solely because we're so smart. We have a video about that, so check it out. What's more, having a big brain may seem to be a disadvantage at first glance. Although in humans, brains make up 2% of our mass, they use a whopping 20% of our blood and oxygen. That's more than twice the amount compared to other primates. That's pretty interesting, because besides having much larger brains, humans are also much weaker. And according to at least one study, those two things may be related. The study in Brain Behavior and Evolution suggests humans developed larger brains at the expense of muscle mass. They call it the energy trade-off hypothesis. Researchers looked at changes in genes that transport glucose, an important energy source, and found that in comparison to chimps, orangutans, and macaques, human genes tend to emphasize providing energy to the brain over the muscles. But that still doesn't explain why we evolved bigger brains to begin with. The answer to that might have more to do with our homies. Yep. Friendships, social relationships, and other complex interactions may just hold the key to our big old brains. It's known as the social brain hypothesis, and it suggests that non-neural intensive tasks like sleeping, eating, or breathing are not really related to brain size. Even problem solving is not wholly responsible for an increase. But thinking about people, keeping track of who is doing what to whom and why and how we fit into those relationships, that takes a ridiculous amount of processing power. And guess what? For humans, being good at interpersonal relationships is one of the best ways to get someone interested in you and eventually propagate the continued existence of this species. That's right, sex. And in fact, this social brain hypothesis kind of makes sense. In an analytical study of skull fossils, researchers from the University of Missouri compared a huge number of potential brain size factors, including climate levels, the number of parasites around, population density, and more. And they found a strong correlation for that last factor. The more densely compact a population, the more likely they'd have bigger brains. So in the end, maybe our evolution is based on social prowess over having big muscles, which is a pretty nice thing to hear when you're a funny guy who only weighs 150. Ladies, get at me. I got it where it counts. Our brains have been through a lot of changes. Even texting changes our brain. And I'll let Trace tell you all about that in this video.
A new study in epilepsy and behavior found that when some people text, either on a phone or a tablet, a whole new brainwave appears. In fact, the researchers said they'd never seen anything like this. This brainwave is unique. When a brainwave changes, it's usually because the brain activity is changing.
What would you rather have? Big muscles or a big brain? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to like and subscribe for new episodes of DNews every day.